Throughout history, foreign armies, merchants, and missionaries have introduced new ways of life into the vast and varied geographical region of South Asia. In time, shaping one of the most diverse populations on the face of the globe. The cultures of South Asia express their heritage through music, dance, and art, and also through day-to-day life, including the clothes people wear and the foods they eat. The wide variety of artistic and social traditions in South Asia reflects the region's history of cultural diversity. At the dawn of civilization, the Indus River Valley was the site of one of the world's earliest settlements, created by a society now known as the Dravidians. The Himalaya Mountains to the north, and the Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal on either side, form natural boundaries around the subcontinent. South Asia remained isolated from outside influence, allowing its inhabitants to develop their own unique ways of life. But early merchants and invading armies periodically gained access through mountain passes and ocean approaches, bringing new ways of life into this isolated region. Aryan invaders pushed the Dravidians south and established kingdoms across the northern plains, laying a foundation for the growth of Hindu culture. Hindu rule ended after 3,000 years when Muslim forces invaded South Asia. The Muslim people constructed the Qutb Minar as a tower of victory after the defeat of the last Hindu kingdom. Muslim and Hindu traditions formed the two most influential cultures of South Asia. But many other cultures also contribute to the character of this region. By the 17th century, South Asia was doing a brisk trade with European nations. By force, Great Britain soon drew most of South Asia into the British Empire, and the native population found itself subject to British rule. The colonial government gained control of South Asia and changed the region through the construction of canals, paved roads, and extensive rail lines, many of which are still in use today. By these efforts, the British laid the foundation of regional unity. At the same time, the tyranny of British rule stimulated the desire for independence. Largely through the brilliant, peaceful leadership of Mohandas Gandhi, India regained independence in 1947. Religious differences divided the newly united region, and Muslims quickly created their own nation named Pakistan, meaning land of the pure. The country was divided into East Pakistan and West Pakistan until 1971, when East Pakistan became the independent country of Bangladesh. The many years of British rule had a lasting effect on the region's character. The English language, for example, is now in common use, often serving as a bridge between the many other languages of South Asia. The sport of cricket is another British import. And other examples are not hard to find. While invasions and migrations brought new cultures into the region, natural boundaries isolated communities for extended periods of time, ensuring that diverse ways of life would develop. Today, this diversity is reflected in a wide variety of regional art. South Asian arts often illustrate ancient stories. South Asian plays are often enacted by puppets. Like many of the dances, South Asian puppetry frequently features folklore, usually enacted by the same cast of characters, such as the snake charmer, the acrobatic horseman, and the magician who can remove his own head. The Kathakali dance enacts other stories from South Asian mythology. Performances require lengthy, elaborate preparation. Kathakali dancers train for many years to create the precise facial and body movements used in the dance. The cinema, a modern art form, has become one of South Asia's largest industries. Artistry is also evident in the architecture of great temples and elaborate monasteries. Many cultures of South Asia celebrate a unique range of religious tradition. Hinduism and Islam are South Asia's most prominent religions. Hinduism originated in 5,000-year-old Aryan beliefs. Hindus worship many gods and goddesses as aspects of a single universal spirit. God is one, says a Hindu proverb. The wise speak of it in different ways. Hindus believe that people are born into different social groups depending on their degree of spiritual perfection. This belief gave rise to the caste system, a rigid social structure which prohibits social classes from intermarriage. People of the lower castes are often restricted to menial, laborious jobs. The caste system has been outlawed, but still influences daily life in many Hindu villages. The mountain country of Nepal is Hindu, as is 80% of India's population. Sometime in their life, Hindus try to make a pilgrimage to the ancient city of Varanasi, where they bathe in the waters of the river Ganges. According to Hindu belief, the waters are spiritually cleansing. Islam is the religion of Afghanistan, Pakistan, Bangladesh, and a large number of India's people. Followers of Islam are called Muslim. Unlike Hindus, Muslims believe in a single God, whom they call Allah. Muslims study the word of Allah through the writings of their prophet Muhammad, compiled in their holy book, the Quran. As Hindus travel to Varanasi, Muslims make a pilgrimage to the Saudi Arabian city of Mecca, the birthplace of Muhammad. In their prayers, Muslims face in the direction of Mecca. Buddhism and Sikhism are native South Asian religions that revised many Hindu traditions. Buddhism was founded on the teachings of Siddhartha Gautama, who lived 2,500 years ago. He became known as Buddha, which means one who is enlightened or awakened. He taught that suffering was a part of human life, but that people could free themselves through a disciplined lifestyle involving purity of mind, nonviolence, and the practice of meditation. Buddhism is the religion of two South Asian countries, the small mountainous country of Bhutan and the small island country of Sri Lanka. Buddhist communities sometimes display prayer flags printed with holy inscriptions, words which the wind is thought to carry to the gods. Prayer wheels are cylinders containing long sheets of paper on which the same prayer is written thousands of times. Turning the wheel clockwise is thought to recite the prayers and is considered a good deed. Compared to Buddhism, Sikhism is a young religion, originating only 500 years ago. Sikhs honor the instructions of their many gurus or teachers. Sikhs are distinguished by their symbolic clothing, especially their turbans. Followers of Jainism are equally distinctive. So complete is their respect for all living creatures, Jain monks wear a mouthpiece to prevent them from accidentally inhaling tiny insects. Articles of clothing, such as robes, turbans, and veils, are often an indication of religious practice. But the wide range of dress in South Asia is also an adaptation to the region's many different climates. Climate shapes a community's culture, in part by determining what grows well in a particular area and what resources are available. The land itself is South Asia's most valuable resource. Vast stretches of rich farmland have made agriculture the region's most important industry, employing 3/4 of the population. tropical fruit is grown along the warm southern coasts of India. Bananas are carried by boat to market, where they can be traded for other goods. Peppers and spices grow well throughout southern India and have long been an important export. Coffee is another cash crop of South Asia, although the region is more often recognized for its tea. Tea grows well in the mountainous areas of India and Sri Lanka. Marshy lowland areas, such as Bangladesh and northeast India, produce enormous quantities of rice. Wheat is grown throughout the northern plain, while cotton is grown on the drier Deccan Plateau. The abundance of cotton supports South Asia's large textile industry, which produces some of the finest fabrics in the world. In tropical southern India, coconut trees support village industries. Coarse fibers are produced from coconut shells. The fibers are braided into a sturdy yarn, which is woven into durable coir mats. In areas with access to coastal waters, fishing is a major industry. The people of Kerala in southern India learned this specialized net design hundreds of years ago from the Chinese. Most South Asians rely upon local resources and their own ingenuity for their livelihood, crafting goods by hand. These small family industries are sometimes called cottage industries because the goods are produced in the home. Many South Asians provide services to earn their income, often without the luxury of an office or place of business. In South Asian agriculture, cattle are used to pull plows and power machinery, but are not often raised as livestock. Most South Asians are restricted from eating meats because of religious beliefs. Muslims are forbidden to eat pork, but do eat lamb. Hindus do not eat beef, and most are vegetarian. In India, where 80% of the population is Hindu, cows wander freely through the streets. It is not unusual to see cattle, horses, or camels drawing carts through traffic alongside buses, cars, and motorbikes. With the huge and fast-growing South Asian population, tiny, inexpensive motor scooters have become a popular means of transportation. Heavy traffic is largely responsible for the air pollution that hangs over South Asian cities in a thick, even haze. The problem has been compounded by the burning of trash in the streets. While scooters are popular in the cities, the far reaches of South Asia are more accessible by train.
That's oil, really hot oil. Has anybody ever seen such a huge pot before? Such a big pan?
Across South Asia, the many cultural traditions have created a wide variety of distinctive dishes. Because so many South Asians avoid eating meat, regional cuisine favors vegetables, such as lentils, flavored with spices and peppers. Kebabs are sometimes grilled on skewers or cooked in a tandoori oven. South Asian dishes are usually served with either rice or bread. Several types of bread are made in South Asia. Chapati is a light bread, often baked on an open flame. Puri is a fried bread. And Romali roti, meaning handkerchief bread, is rolled extremely thin before it is baked. A variety of sweet desserts complement South Asian meals, such as the pretzel-shaped jalebi or the round gulab jamun, usually served hot. Fresh coconut milk is a delicious drink of the South Asian tropics. In many other areas, a sweet juice is ground fresh from sugarcane stalks. The diversity of regional food is yet another example of the overall cultural diversity of the South Asian people, one of the most unique populations in the world. Today, as always, South Asia is a land of intrigue and wonder, maintaining a rich heritage from the ancient past, through the recent past, and into the ever-changing present.
Meri yaad karta hai to mujhe